every time you are near. Just like me, they long to be close to you. Why do stars fall down from the sky every time you walk by? Just like me, they long to be close to you. On the day that you were born, the angels got together and decided to create a dream come true. So they sprinkled
to all, and welcome as we prepare to say farewell to this lovely man. A little over 5 years ago was when I first met you all, when I conducted the farewell ceremony for Lotta, and I stand here today now as a friend rather than the celebrant to help ease you through this pain that is felt by us all. We are, as circumstances have deemed, a small gathering. But had we not been in the midst of the strangest times I certainly have ever known, I know that this room, and probably outside too, would have been full of family and friends, all gathered in disbelief that such a thing could happen to Nicky, of all people. Later in the year, when things are hopefully easier, there will be a memorial ceremony where we shall gather again in greater numbers to show our love and appreciation for having had this lovely man in our lives. So we're going to remember him today with some words from Erland, from Hugh and Natasha. We will have some time for quiet reflection and a little poetry. But most of all, with love. We shall affect a gentle farewell and later leave here with some words that I hope will bring you a little comfort as we begin our lives again, adjusting to the natural changes that we will now have to make without the physical presence of Nicholas in them. What we will have, however, are the many wonderful memories that we have created over the years to cherish and treasure for the rest of our own lives. Nicky's light may have dimmed, but the pilot light is still on in our hearts, and he will be around us all for a very long time to come. Erland has asked me to share these words with you now, which I'm honoured to do. I feel like the most fortunate person in the world to have spent the last 15 years of my life with you. I couldn't have asked for a more loving companion and life partner. We lived an extraordinary life together, filled with love, family, friends, and adventures. In the words of Renata Suzuki, I wish you knew how much of you there is in everything I do. It can be the smallest thing, trivial, mundane, but you're there. Under the surface of it somewhere. I wish you knew how I carry you with me always. Everywhere I go. Thank you. I also have some words from Hugh, and I'd like to share those. There's no training for parenting, so the way children develop is largely up to the individual. And, to my delight, Nicholas appeared to encompass the values that I have tried to follow, as he progressively became a caring and perfect friend. I have been spoiled to have him living a few minutes away with Erland as his partner in exactly the same mould. It is, of course, tragic that we have lost someone who could have continued to contribute so much to us and to society. And now from Natasha. The world needs to stop spinning because you're not here. Having you as my twin brother has been so fabulous. You always made me feel I'd never be alone. I feel a piece of me is missing. You injected happiness into my life. Amelie, Poppy, and Freddie will treasure their memories of their mischievous uncle. And Johnny has lost the brother that he had gained. Our world is forever altered without you in it. Thank you all so much for those lovely words. Now, before we say farewell and leave Nicholas to his rest, I should just like to ask you to remember him in your own ways. Think about what brought you into your life, what made you tick. Remember the trips to France, the wonderful dinner parties at Emperor's Gate, where once at Christmas I won the prize for having the almond in my dessert. Anything that you want to store away, you can. We all have memories that are different because that's how our minds work. So they will all be unique. Keep them safe because they will help you later, maybe not just yet. The picture you want may be a bit fuzzy, or it may not, as the pain of losing Nicky so suddenly is still so very raw. But when you are ready, a clear, sharp, focused image will appear and stay with you always. You may also use this time for silent prayer, should you so wish, whilst we listen to La Mer, sung by Charles Trenet.
La mer qu'on voit danser le long du golfe clair a des reflets d'argent. La mer, des reflets changeants sous la pluie. La mer d'été confond ces blancs moutons avec les anges si purs, la mer, bergère d'azur infinie. Je voyais près des étangs ces grands roseaux mouillés. Voyez ces oiseaux blancs et ces maisons rouillées. La mer les a bercées le long des golfes clairs et d'une chanson d'amour. La mer a bercé mon cœur pour la vie, la mer, qu'on va danser le long des golfes clairs, à des reflets d'argent, la mer, des reflets changeants sous la pluie, la mer. Au ciel d'été, confond ces blancs moutons avec les anges si purs, la mer, bergère d'azur infinie. Voyez, près des étangs, ces grands roseaux mouillés. Voyez, ces oiseaux blancs et ces maisons rouillées. La mer, les a bercées le long des golfes clairs et d'une chanson d'amour là-bas a bercé mon cœur. Pour la vie.
Now, and if you are able, would you please stand for the farewell? The writer and Dr. Oliver Sacks wrote, "My predominant feeling is one of gratitude. I have loved and been loved. I have been given much, and I have given something in return. Above all, I have been a sentient being, a thinking animal on this beautiful planet, and that, in itself, has been an enormous privilege and adventure." So here, in this final act, in sorrow but without fear, we gently yield the body of Nicholas Kingsley Palliser Dibley, Nicky, to its end with nature. Nicholas, it is because of the love that you have shared with Erland and your family, the friendships you have forged over the years of your life, that those gathered here in your honour to be a part of this intimate ceremony are able to let you go to your rest in peace. Well, the family have chosen a Joyce Grenfell poem for the blessing called "If I Should Go." If I should go before the rest of you, break not a flower, nor inscribe a stone, nor when I am gone, speak in a Sunday voice, but be the usual selves that I have known. Weep if you must. Parting is hell. But life goes on. So sing as well. Now, whilst you're still standing, if you would care to, please join me in the words of the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. In a little while, we shall be leaving the peace of this place and going back in safety to our everyday lives, to quietly reflect on today and how this has hopefully gently eased you into the next phase. Be gentle with yourselves. Talk to each other. Phone each other. Phone me. Do anything that will help you to keep the memory of Nicky firmly in place. Chat about him. Laugh about things you laughed at together. And be thankful that we had such a character in our lives and in our hearts. I'm going to close with a quote from A.A. Milne's Winnie the Pooh. How lucky we are to have had something that makes saying goodbye so hard.